morning to one and all. Myself Swati. I'm working as an assistant professor in the department of ECO, St. Martin's Engineering College. In the last video, we already discussed about the what is signal and what is system, what is the classification of the signals and system. Mainly, the signals are classified into two types. What are those? Continuous time signal and discrete time signal. Okay? Signals and system will be broadly depends upon their nature and characteristics. It will be classified into two types: continuous time signal and the discrete time signal. Again, these continuous and discrete time signals will be further classified under into five types. What are those five types? Already discussed in the last video. What is continuous time signal? What is discrete time signal? In this video, we have to discuss further what is the continuous time signal and discrete time signal further classified into five types. What are those five types? We have discussed in this video. First one is the periodic and non-periodic. Okay. Second one is the even and odd signal. And third one is the deterministic and the random signal. Deterministic and the random signal. And fourth one is the real and complex signal. Real and complex signal. And fifth one is the energy and power signal. Okay, coming to the periodic and non-periodic signal. The signal is said to be periodic. The signal is said to be periodic means the signal will be repeat at every time interval of instant time, that is T. The periodic signal will satisfy the condition. What is we also represent the periodic signal in mathematical form? That is x of t equals to x of small t plus capital T. Here t is the time, capital T is the constant. Okay, the signal is said to be periodic means it satisfies this condition. Okay, signal is said to be periodic means that it will repeat the regular time interval with instant of time T. Okay, this is the example of the periodic signal. Okay, periodic signal means the signal will be varying continuously with every instant of time period T. Okay, again the cycle will be repeated. Okay, if this condition will be satisfied means the signal is said to be periodic. The index will be represented by the x of t and by x axis will be represented by the letter t. This format will be in the continuous time signal. Okay, we have to represent this in periodic signal in the discrete time signal. In the discrete time signal, the signal will be repeated every time interval with the discrete time signals. Okay, again the signal will be repeated at discrete time signals. Okay, this is the total time period. Again the cycle will be repeated. Integer, it will be x of n. Here x is the dependent variable, n is the independent variable. Here x is the dependent variable, t is the independent variable. Okay, in this periodic and non-periodic signal, periodic signal means it repeats the time interval at every instant of time t. Non-periodic means in this periodic signal, the reciprocal of the frequency, the angular frequency will be angular frequency w equal to 2 pi f. This is the angular frequency of the periodic signal. We have to represent in the mathematical form. The w is the angular frequency here, f is the frequency. Frequency is the reciprocal of the time. F equals to 1 by t. We have to represent here. W omega equal to 2 pi by T. So what is the T here? T equals to 2 pi by omega. Okay, this is the constant here. It repeats the every time interval of T. This is the periodic signal. Coming to the non-periodic signal, this condition is not satisfied. This condition is not satisfied means the signal is said to be non-periodic means this condition is not satisfied. Not satisfied means the signal will be not repeated at every instant of time T. This condition is called as non-periodic signal. The example of the non-periodic signal is the, it is in the continuous time signal, the signal will be not repeated. This is the time interval T. This is the signal will be not repeated. This signal is called as the non-periodic signal. This will be the example for the continuous time signal. This will be represented in the discrete time signal as the, this is x of n, this is n. Okay, the signal will be not repeated here. Okay, this is the discrete time signal. The signal will be not repeated here. This is the time interval T. This is about the periodic and non-periodic signal. Periodic means signal will be repeated it after every time interval of T. Non-periodic means signal will be not repeated. Okay? This is about periodic and non-periodic signal. In the periodic signal, we have to find the angular frequency. The frequency, for finding the frequency, the time is the reciprocal of that frequency equals to 1 by T. Omega angular frequency W equals to 2 pi. F, we have to represent the F in place of F, 2 pi by T. T equals to 2 pi by omega. Coming to the next one, even and odd signal. A signal, continuous time signal x of t or discrete time signal x of n, the both continuous and discrete time signals are said to be even condition, even signal and the odd signal. Okay, the signal is said to be even, it will satisfy the this condition. The signal is said to be even means it satisfies the x of minus t equals to x of t for all t. The signal is said to be even means it will satisfy the this condition. X of minus t, x of negative means equals to x of t. This, if this condition is satisfied, then the signal is said to be even. Okay? Now, even signals are symmetrical about the original of the axis of the time t. Okay? That's why this even signal is called as the symmetrical signals. Okay, why we call as the even signals or symmetrical signal means the even signals are the symmetrical about the origin of the vertical axis T at the time interval T time signal. So that's why these even signals are called as symmetrical signals. Okay, for even signals, the signal is said to be even means this condition will be satisfied. What is this condition? X of minus t equals to t for all t. Okay, this is the continuous time signal. For discrete time signal, x of minus n equals to x of n for all n. This condition will be satisfied in the discrete time signal. Okay, coming to the next one, that is odd signal. And we have to represent the this one in the signal form. Okay, the best example for the even signal is the cosine wave. Okay, this is time t and this is the x of t. Okay. Here the signal is said to be x of minus t equals to x of t. This is the negative 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2. We have to represent like this means. So the signal will be satisfies the condition. This is the example for the even signal. Okay, the signal is satisfied or not. So the x of minus 1 equals to x of 1. Okay, this is the condition for the even signal in the continuous time signal. Okay, in the discrete time signal, we have to represent like this. Asymmetrical signals. Why it is called as asymmetrical signal means it is the odd signals are also called as the asymmetrical signals means the it will be about the origin. If the odd signals are asymmetric about the origin of the axis the time interval t. So that's why odd signals are called as asymmetrical signals. Okay, the signal is said to be odd signal means it will satisfy the condition in x of minus t equals to minus x of t. In the continuous time signal, in the discrete time signal, the signal is said to be satisfies the condition is x of minus n equals to minus x of n. This is for all t. This is for all n. Okay, the signal is said to be odd means satisfies the this condition in the continuous time signal. This satisfies the discrete time signal in the x of minus n equals to minus x of n. The example of this odd signal is the sine wave. The example of the odd signal is the sine wave. Okay, the best example of the this odd signal is this will be satisfies the this condition. The signal is said to be odd means it will satisfy this condition. So this is now continuous time signal. This will be in the discrete time signal. Okay, in this continuous time signal, we have to represent it by the x of t and t. Okay, see signal the this condition will be satisfied. Okay, x of minus t equals to minus x of t for all t. Okay, x of minus t. This is the plus 1 and this is the minus 1. X of minus t is the minus x of t for producing the odd signal. This is in the continuous time signal. In the discrete time signal, will be represented by the x of 1. So this condition will be satisfied in the discrete time signal. This condition will be satisfied in the continuous time signal. The even signal is called as symmetrical signal. Odd signal is called as asymmetrical signal. Why it is called as symmetrical and asymmetrical means even signals will be satisfies the condition of symmetrical about the origin of the every instant of time t. Odd signal is the asymmetrical about the origin of the time instant t. This is about the even and odd signal. The signal is said to be even means satisfies the x of minus t equals to x of t. The signal is said to be odd signal, it will satisfy the condition is x of minus t equals to minus x of t. Okay, next is the deterministic and the random signal. Coming to the deterministic and random signal. Okay, the random signal is also called as the undeterministic signal. That is undeterministic or random signal. Why it is called as random signal? Undeterministic or random signal. This undeterministic signal is it will be having the nature of the random nature. That's why this signal, undeterministic signal, is also called as the random signal. First, we will discuss about the deterministic signal. Deterministic signal.
30 seconds.
Okay, the deterministic signal. Okay, coming to the deterministic signal, the signal will be exhibiting a necessary condition of the phase and magnitude. Here, this phase and magnitude will be having the certainty condition. Okay, there is no phase and random signal is here. This deterministic and random deterministic signal will be expressed in the mathematical form. Okay. In the next video, we will discuss about this deterministic and random signal. Thank you.